Hello guys and welcome to Paris Models once again. It's about time to open the box and start building the Phantom. What do you think? So let's open the box once again. I managed to get the Quinta Studio decals for the cockpit this time, so I'm going to be using them ones. So as usual, let's have another quick look at the instructions and probably start with the cockpit. Okay, the instructions tell us to start with the side walls and remove some ejection molds, paint, put the closed air refueling probe at the back. Probably we'll skip that, we'll do it later, and the cockpit. So let's get the parts out and take it from there. I'm using some Tamiya cutters to remove the parts. And then again, as you see, I don't cut near the part. I leave a bit of a sprue. Then cut the back walls again. And then I'm coming with my God hand cutters. And I'm removing the remaining sprue cut. And then some ultimate files for cleaning. Cut and clean. So I'll do the same for all the cockpit parts and come back later. So let's start putting some parts together. I'm using some Tamiya extra thin cement. So, following the instructions for Quinta Studio, and we have the part S3, we need to remove this detail here. So we can put the pieces from the decals. And then again, part S16. I have already sanded it and there's no detail anymore. I've sanded it. So I'm gonna use some sanding sticks and remove this detail here. Again, you have to just be gentle and sand lightly. So that's all the details sanded from the side wall. I'm going to do the same on the other parts as per the instructions from Quinta Studio. So we need to remove the details here, and then on part S6, and then the details down there. I'll be doing that and I'll come back, and then as well as the instrument panels. So after I sanded all the detail in order to put the Quinta Studio decals, I mounted everything on some cocktail sticks and piece of wood ready for a painting. So for the main color of the cockpit, I'm gonna use Guns H308. So I'm gonna paint everything, and I'm gonna use an Infinity 2-in-1 airbrush. So I'll continue painting the cockpit parts and come back after. We have to remove the fuselage halves in order to glue them together and paint the inside of the cockpit. So I put the refueling probe cover and look at that. Look the fit, it's amazing. Again, that's an amazing kit. The fit is excellent. So I'm gonna glue these two halves together now. Just make sure that everything fits up, and then look at that again. That's amazing. Amazing. I'm lost for words for this kit. So I'm gonna come now and paint the inside walls of the cockpit. I'm picking up some of the details with acrylic paints and a small brush. Now that I finished all the details, I created a wash with black and burnt amber oil, and I'm going to apply it on the panels to bring out the detail. So I'm going to keep applying the wash and come later when it's dry. Now that the wash is dry, we're coming with a soft brush, moistened with thinners, and we remove it from where we don't want it. And that creates a filter of dirt and makes the parts look weathered. So we moisten the brush every time and clean it. It takes some time, but the results are great. So I'll keep doing that for all the parts and come back when they're done. In order to enhance a bit more the shadows and the light on the panels, I'm using some burnt amber at the bottom of the parts, neat burnt amber that I blend with a soft brush, so as to create some shadows and dirt on the bottom areas. So again, some like neat burnt amber that I blend with a soft brush. To create these shadows and dirt at the bottom of its equipment panel. Then for the highlights, I'm using some titanium white, again, oils. Again, with a soft brush, I'm blending it. That's the advantage of using oils, that you can blend them as much as you want. So when you put them all together, it has that dirty look. So I'm gonna start with number 21, which is the side console. I have the consoles here. I'm gonna take the part. Number 21. And again, I'm going to treat them as decals. I have some water here. I'm going to put it in, leave it for a couple of seconds. That's a decal. It's moving from the paper. And for extra strength, I'm going to add some micro crystal clear. Cotton bud to remove the water from underneath the decal. And I'm gonna let it dry. That's it. Continue with the next one. I'm gonna let it rest a bit. And then some more of the panels. The detail of these decals is amazing. The 3D print is exquisite. Better than all the PE or your hand can do. Again, we press to remove all the water underneath. And we'll let them dry. I'll do the rest of the cockpit. I'll do the instrument panels and I'll come back later. Before we close the cockpit, the last thing we have to do is apply a coat of matte varnish just to take out the shyness. I'm using Tamiya XF86. So now just a case of gluing the cockpit parts together and then call it finished. Again, I'm using Tamiya extra thin cement. And I'll keep gluing the rest of the parts. And that's the finished cockpit of the Quinta Studio parts in.